So there was this guy who recently went viral for quitting his job and tracking down Logan Paul at some sort of public event for Jake Paul's recent fight, and then telling him that he's a super fan, basically stalker, who would do absolutely anything to work for him, saying that he would even work for free just to be in the presence of a godlike figure like Logan Paul. This man is very certain that this is his purpose in life.
I quit my job legit 2 days ago. I came up here, took a risk. I'm originally from Ohio.
Did you sneak up here?
No, I didn't sneak in here. I didn't sneak. What do you mean sneak up?
Like
here?
On stage? Or are you just like?
Yes, I did.
It's one of the sneak videos.
I'm sorry.
Did you print the ticket and stuff?
No, like, I just needed to talk to you.
But here's the kicker to this whole situation. This man claims to have quit a $100,000 a year job at the age of 22.
Before I approached him, he was bragging about making $3 million. I make $100,000 a year. I'm 22. I do make $100,000. That's cool. And I want to act. I want to do these things.
Which honestly, I do not believe, but for the sake of the video, let's just pretend that it is true. I mean, talk about an absolute idiot. And not necessarily because he wanted to work for Logan Paul, but the way he went about it, failing to develop any sort of logical plan, and basically just cold call approaching him like this, was obviously not gonna work. I mean, this is almost as cringy as when Fousey was stalking Drake all weekend, just waiting for his opportunity to beg him to be in his free concert, all because Allah apparently came to him in a vision and told him to do so. In the book Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, he discusses the man who talked his way into partnership with Thomas Edison. At the time, Edison was already world famous for his inventions, aka patents that he stole from others, and this guy Edwin was pretty much just a regular bum. But he showed up at his office one day begging Edison to give him a job. And after a little bit of persuasion, he actually did end up giving him some little piddlefuck job in his office. But that was really all Edwin needed, was his foot in that door, because years later he was partners with Thomas Edison, standing at the top of the world with his hero. And so I'm thinking maybe this guy read that book and went a little bit wild, got a little bit too inspired.
I'm trying to talk about business, trying to get a job. Like, I want to do media.
What are you good at?
I was 70 dances. I did like
What's
that.
What's your TikTok?
I did that video, you know, like going
oh,
like
you,
that.
Oh, you know. Oh, so you really got what it takes.
Yeah, I don't.
Then why would I
need a mentor.
Job? Why would I do that?
I want to be like.
And please do not tell me that this whole thing is the result of some acid trip where this guy had a spiritual awakening and decided that his purpose in life was to work for Logan Paul Enterprises.
I didn't have connections and people around. I have Jake. That's it. Do you have a brother? Do you have people? Friends?
I don't.
Friends? You got friends. You got amigos.
I don't.
You don't have friends?
I don't. I swear to God. I'm here by myself.
Where are you from? Go make content. Do stuff with your friends. I'm glad you quit your job. It takes balls to do that, bro. But like now you got to act.
Try to make a step.
I'm
new
not.
Media.
But I'm not the guy directly,
you're
right?
You're the guy.
No, bro. My team is this. Relax. I'm not the guy. Like, life isn't about handouts. You know what I'm saying?
I know. I'm not trying to get a handout. I'm not trying to get
what
a handout.
What are you trying to do?
And I really do think Logan told him all of the right things there. He's probably gotten pitched like this millions of times over and by people with a lot more to offer and who show a lot more potential than this clown. He even asked him what he does and this guy really had no answer. He has no reason for why Logan should randomly give him a chance. Let me just tell you guys this. People who work hard to do what they want in their life do not pity those who sit around and wish they could do this or wish they could do that, but never actually do anything about it. And look, dude, it's great that you want to move to LA and work for your idol, but what have you really done? What groundwork have you laid? Where is your foundation, sir? I think a lot of people get obsessed with the end result without putting in the work. Also, 99% of people burn out quickly trying to live this lifestyle this dude thinks he wants. And it sounds like he's having a quarter-life crisis. This would be like showing up to work as an engineer and not even having a high school diploma. I mean, it's really nothing but a pipe dream. I've also heard stories that when Big Sean was trying to get on, he knew Kanye was at his local radio station and he rapped for him for like 20 minutes straight. And though he didn't get signed that day or even make like a working relationship with Kanye, he planted a seed in Kanye's head that wouldn't grow until he bumped into him 2 years later and managed to talk his way into Kanye listening to some of his music. But if he had never laid the foundation and rapped on his own with his friends, he would have flopped. Luck really is when preparation meets opportunity. I'll say that one more time for those of you that aren't paying attention. Luck really is when preparation meets opportunity. Maybe this could work with someone like Nelk, but Logan seems to keep a pretty small list of people he keeps around him, like any sort of smart celebrity. And I'm sure he sees most of his employees as people he can really trust, pretty much like family. Overall, it was a valiant effort, sir, but the fact that you thought this was gonna work is a little bit insane. Let me know what you guys think about this down below. Should Logan have given him a job? Was he right to kind of put him in his place? As always, I want to thank you guys for dropping a like on today's video, subscribing if you're not, and following me on my social medias. That's at Jamari Speaks on both Twitter and Instagram. But as you guys know, there's some other news out here that needs to get covered. So it's been your boy, the Tan Superman, and I'm out. Peace!